Hi, this is Carol Ford, talking to you from New Jersey.
This is Linda Groundwater. Greetings from all the way down under in Australia.
And this is Dee Young. Hello from Connecticut.
We're all very busy producing our first feature episode, but we know waiting is tough.
So we thought, let's do a sort of interim episode to keep you a little entertained as we work, to hold you over.
If you followed our work or read Bob Crane, the definitive biography, you know that Bob was a radio pioneer. In fact, his radio colleagues have referred to him as a radio genius.
Here's what KNX wrote in a station promotional brochure. Bob Crane is, quote, the wildest, funniest morning program in radio. Besides keeping you posted on Sig alerts, weather, sports, and the best of the good music, Bob pokes fun at just about everybody, including his boss, his sponsors, and his guests. He's the only radio personality who hosts leading film and TV stars for live, unrehearsed interviews daily. End quote.
But it's really unfortunate that most people don't know very much about Bob's extensive work in radio. When I talk with people about Bob, they are stunned to discover how important he was to the radio and broadcasting industry. So in this podcast series, we're going to delve into Bob's radio work like never before.
From his official start at WLEA in Hornell, New York, to his ambitious climb through stations in Connecticut, including WBIS in Bristol and WLIZ and WICC in Bridgeport, to ultimately Hollywood at KNX, where in the decades following his death, the media often referred to him as King of the LA Airwaves. There's a story to that, too, that we'll discuss later. Bob stayed close to radio after he left KNX in 1965, throughout his time on Hogan's Heroes, and all through the 1970s.
Bob never forgot his roots either. In January 1976, he returned to WICC to help the station celebrate its 50th anniversary. At that time, I had been employed at WICC for just about 2 weeks. And since I was Nicky New Kid, I didn't know that Bob had been program director and on air back in the early 50s. I had the very good fortune to meet Bob as he happily greeted most of the staff. I'll never forget shaking his hand with that big smile of his and the twinkle in his eyes. WICC on-air personality Al Warren interviewed Bob that day, and during their interview, Big Al referred to Bob as a living legend. And he was.
We'll be discussing all of it. The fact that Bob doesn't get the proper recognition for his radio work is simply tragic. Because he was more than just someone who worked in radio before Hogan's Heroes. He changed radio.
For now, we'll give you a very brief sampling of Bob Crane's radio work. And the following two clips are from his KNX radio show. The first is a commercial for Winston Cigarettes. Keep in mind when you listen that Bob performs the voice of the Ludwig von Drake type character, posing as his engineer. Bob pre-recorded the voice, and then live on the air, he interacted with the recording, as if this were a real person in the studio with him.
And the second is a rare interview Bob Crane conducted with the beautiful Marilyn Monroe. This is the only known surviving clip of this interview.
During the early 1960s, KNX added a new component to Bob's radio show, that of the celebrity interview. From about 1961 through the time Bob left KNX in 1965, some 3,000 people were guests on Bob's show, and most were celebrities. And Bob was smart. He had his guests sign transfer of copyright forms to him, so he was able to use his celebrity interviews on other shows long after he left KNX, including the United States Armed Forces Radio Network and KMPC in Los Angeles.
And we're going to get to all of that in future episodes. Now, sit back and enjoy these two segments from The Bob Crane Show, as originally aired over KNX-CBS Radio in Hollywood.
Today, Jack Chapman is probably more widely known than I am. I can go out, make personal appearances. People don't know me. You know, they can't see me. You'd be surprised how many people can't see me. But anyway, Jack has a feeling that he is the important one. Even in playing records, he doesn't think the singers are important, the musicians, nothing.
Musicians mean nothing, the singers, now, the dancers.
Yeah, I know.
None of them mean nothing.
I know, Jim.
And it's true, because if you don't have a good engineer, you're never going to get to Cleveland. I'm going to tell you about tape. Now, you take a piece of tape like this, and you put one piece over here on one side of the mouth, one piece on this.
No, that's not the kind of tape, Jim.
What am I doing? That's the wrong kind
of
tape.
That's not the tape. Put the right tape on.
A tape machine, you don't use that kind of
tape. Right, you put the right tape
on. Like for bandages or something like that.
Put the right tape on. This is just to show you what a great engineer can be for a show. Go ahead.
Altogether different.
Yeah, altogether.
You put the tape on this side, and then you put it through a little thing over here, and then you twist it around over there, and you put another reel here, and then you turn on the machine, and here's what you hear on the tape.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
One of the all-time great engineers.
Up front in the tobacco end.
Always gets things absolutely perfect.
Winston gives you filter blend.
Thanks to the keen-sightedness of our engineer.
Up front in the tobacco end.
The flavor comes from filter blend.
All right, give us the message there, Charlie.
You stiff near worn that 9 years.
Oh, am I, Jim? Jim. Oh, Jim, you got the tapes backwards. Jim.
How about that? That's backwards.
Well, put it.
Well, I'm gonna fix that. When you hear a tape that's put on backwards like that, it sounds, you know, like it's really ridiculous.
Well, I'll put the
but
thing.
But that isn't the way it is,
right,
because then when
out.
You turn it around and you play it forward, we're gonna re-thread it over here. I put it over here, play it forward for you,
and
now you are going to see what it really sounds like.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
You should have left it the other way.
Filter Blend, Winston's own combination of golden, flavorful tobacco, specially selected, then specially processed, is why Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
That's it. Winston does taste good like a cigarette should. And over KNX-CBS Radio in Los Angeles, 1070 on your AM dial and 93.1 on your FM dial, this is Bob Crane on...
For the life of us, we couldn't find the complete Marilyn Monroe interview, which we did about four years ago, I guess. We only managed to find two short portions of the interview that we did with Marilyn out at 20th Century Fox. And at that time, she was making the picture Let's Make Love with Eve Montan and Tony Randall. And she came into the room in a beautiful slack outfit. I thought,
well,
is this a dancer outfit thing that you
do? No, just a pair of slacks and... sort of an old sweater.
That's a nice old sweater. Nice old pair of
slacks. Are we on, Bob?
Yeah.
Well, I've been rehearsing all day.
Yeah.
I'm still out of breath.
All right, I'll let you get your breath for just a minute there. Marilyn, I've often wondered, being the sex symbol of the movies, are you ever offended when men pass by and then whistle and things like that?
I'm honored.
Really?
Of course.
Do you think most women are?
Of course.
That's the high point of... is that a big compliment?
Yes. Well, how about when you whistle at a girl or you feel like whistling?
How is Jack Lemmon to work with?
Wonderful. He's a wonderful actor.
He's a very funny guy. You're working with a funny guy in the new picture, Tony Randall.
Yes, very funny.
Do you want to know something? This will knock you back on the back of the couch here. I was supposed to test for this picture.
You?
Did you mean that with all the... was inferred by the you? I read a lot into the line. No, really, the part that they finally gave to Tony Randall.
Mm-hmm.
The press agent part.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
Well, Bob, it's nice meeting you, and hope I see you again.
The late Marilyn Monroe in an interview we did at 20th Century Fox, for which we want to thank another gentleman who has since passed away. He was one of the first people we met coming to the coast here 8 years ago, was the late Jerry Wall.
Flipside, the true story of Bob Crane, is owned and produced by Carol M. Ford Productions. All rights reserved. No portion of this podcast may be used without written permission. The Winston Cigarettes commercial and Bob Crane's interview clip with Marilyn Monroe originally aired over KNX-CBS Radio in Hollywood, circa 1960 or 1961. For archived episodes of this podcast and to learn more about all of our work about Bob Crane, visit voteforbobcrane.org. That's vote, the number 4, bobcrane.org. You can also subscribe to this podcast on iTunes, Google Play Music, Spotify, Stitcher, TuneIn Radio, our hosting site Spreaker, and other various podcast delivery services.